I think I'll read mostly, entirely sonnets from here on in, and I won't be very long. It only takes about a minute and 35 seconds to read a sonnet. The first one I wrote, well, a little backstory here. My partner, Alicia, once said to me, "You're always writing poems, but you've never written me a love poem." And I said, "Well, there was that limerick." It's true, there was a bunch of limericks. They weren't very naughty or anything. It was part of our courtship. We were teaching assistants together when we were both doing grad studies at Dell. There's a teacher I know named Alicia, neither wife, widow, girl, witch, nor geisha. If you ask, "What the hell?" she'll say, "You're doing well. I'm a devil disguised as a teacher." But that's not really enough. So I did embark on writing her a sonnet about our relationship. And after you've written one, you realize that that's not nearly enough. So hopefully there will be many. And when there are many, they'll be numbered, but for now they have titles. The very first one I wrote was the very first one I published, which I thought was a good omen. It actually won third place in the Banff Center Brits Carman Award for 2010. The award that Prairie Fire gives out. I like third. It's like there were some things about this poem that we didn't like, but we could not pass it by. That's a good position to be in. The winner in that year was Jacob McCarthy-Mooney's Young Spirit Midnight, which went on to be in the Best Canadian Poetry 2012, so I can complain that the competition was kind of stiff. Love Sonnet. This was not written to win you, this gift. I only began when I could be sure that a sonnet would not be decisive, but bycatch, an accidental figure, as the nonsense text of fingernail chaff, or the horizons drawn by stranded hairs, cipher the whole occasion of the bath. So does my song your general welfare. But see me in it. See how hard I tried, or how casually, as I may deserve, scrub the world off on a man-made tide. I'll be here listening to that compact surf, making a note or two on how it feels to wait for the thud of your squeaky heels.